The idea is to develop a device that can be used at the point of care. So we are aiming to dramatically widen the settings in which HIV can be monitored and diagnosed. Our collaborators at the Royal Free and UCL Hospital see about 15% of the total UK HIV population. And those patients have tests to measure virological and immunological markers in their blood. The virological markers give a measure of the activity of the virus, and so are important for looking at patients once they're diagnosed. The immunological markers tell us how the disease is affecting the individual patient's immune system. At the moment, the state of the art is that samples have to be sent off to these specialist hospitals. Assays can take several days before the results come back, and this inevitably leads to delays in the way the patient is handled. Our vision for this technology is that it will allow patients to be tested in non-specialist settings, so moving first of all from these tertiary centres to district hospitals, then to GP surgeries, and eventually actually also to developing countries. These are different generations of the instruments. This is the one we first developed. This is now a smaller prototype device where we've shrunk down the dimensions of the device, moving increasingly towards a handheld device that can be used to monitor and diagnose HIV. At the moment it's in a fridge, but that's to control the temperature. In stage one, the device will be a benchtop device. So it will be of a similar size to the devices that you see here currently, but it will integrate a number of new features. The patient will be able to test their own blood or within a GP's surgery. The blood will be loaded onto a cartridge, which will be inserted into one of these devices to read the signal, the amount of the markers present in their blood. In the second stage, we are looking to engage with industrial partners and develop a handheld device, a device that could be used anywhere in the world by non-trained specialists. And we have collaborators, for example, in Ghana, who are in desperate need of such a device. It has the potential to transform the way that HIV is diagnosed and monitored in the UK, but also in developing countries.